Welcome, guys, to the first episode of the H3 Report Live, where we look at all the spicy memes throughout the week that don't quite deserve their own video, but are definitely worth talking about. And this week, we have got an excellent, excellent lineup. We have Bill Nye. We have the return of Ethan Bradberry. What he's up to, you won't believe. Make sure no skipping, because there's surprises throughout. TechRax is back with some silly, goofy memes. So let's start from the top with Bill Nye. If you guys haven't seen this video, My Sex Junk, it's an excerpt from Bill Nye Saves the World, his new Netflix series. And there's been a ton of controversy about this show. I mean, the criticism I would land against Bill Nye's new show is that it's just not good. It's just really bad. There's very little science. There's very little exploration of the scientific method. It's very opinion-based. And I've been kind of trying to think, what's the best way to approach it? Because on one hand, I agree with the message, but there's definitely something that really rubs me the wrong way, and I'm trying to explore it and find out what it is. Let me show you guys the video, and we can discuss it as we watch. So this is called My Sex Junk, and this is Bill Nye.
Seriously, this next thing I feel is very special. This is a cool little segment. You know this woman from Crazy Ex-Girlfriend. Please give it up.
Y'all know this lady, Rachel Bloom, from Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, the hit show that everybody's seen and knows. Have you heard of Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, Hila? I never heard of it. Everybody knows this girl, Rachel Bloom.
For Rachel Bloom!
Full of choice, yep. But must I choose between only John or Joyce? All my options only, hard or moist.
So first of all, right out the gate, it's like so obscenely graphic. Are my only options hard or moist? I don't know. How many options are there? What's between hard and moist? Like, what sex options are there between that? Do we need more options than that? Regardless, it's very graphic, it's very obscene. It seems to be geared towards kids, like the whole show and experience. But on the other hand, it's super, super graphic. Hard or moist, dude? I don't even know, man. What's up between hard and moist? Jello sex toys? What is this?
My vagina has its own voice.
Hell yeah.
A metaphorical voice. Sometimes I do a voice for my vagina. Please don't tell me I'm the only one who does that.
I do a voice for my vagina. Sounds like this. Hila, what's your vagina voice sound like?
It's got no voice.
Sounds like Hila says it has no voice. Please tell me she's not the only one that does that. You're telling me your vagina doesn't have its own voice? Get with the times, Hila. Wow, she is so behind. Vaginas are supposed to have their own voice in 2017. I've watched this so many times, I literally remembered it. Cause my sex junk is so
much more than either
or.
Power bottle or a top off.
Yep.
Versatile love may have some butt stuff.
It's like, all right, well, again, it's too graphic. It's too graphic. Why are we talking about butt stuff in a kid's show? Like, what does this have to do with gender fluidity and like? So here's why I'm confused about this video. I support like gay rights and trans rights, and I think these people, you know, deserve like credit and in the world, in the mainstream. But the way they're approaching it, I think, is problematic for both sides, because they're kind of portraying like trans and gay people as like super hyper sexualized, almost sexual deviants. Like, you're making a song about basically screwing anything that's you come in contact with, about doing butt stuff, and it seems like it's for kids, and it's super hypersexualized, and I'm not sure that that's how gay and trans people want to be represented in the world, right? I feel like they probably want to be considered as normal people, which they are, just like straight people. So in a way, you have people on the conservative, very extreme right who look at this video, and that's a lot of people who are criticizing it, and be like, wow, these people are sexual deviants, this is a mental illness, look, this is proof. And I, on the other hand, I don't think it's a mental illness, it's completely acceptable, normal. But the way they're portraying it, they're trying to defend these people, but I think they're actually hurting the cause by portraying them as like sexual deviants or hyposexualized people who just want to fuck anything that comes in contact. Here, listen, continue to listen. And don't be afraid to dance and sing along. It's what?
It's not a kid's show.
But okay, so Hila says it's not a kid's show. And I agree that the target demo doesn't seem to be kids, but this whole song and dance, what self-respecting adult would actually get down with this? It is framed like packaged for kids. I can't imagine any adult being like, yeah, get some butt stuff. Oh, like it doesn't make sense. The target and their actual product don't line up. So it seems like kid. For me, the package seems like it's for kids. And even if it's not, my message is the same.
There's nothing taboo about sex stew.
Sex stew.
Just add salt or drop.
There's nothing taboo about sex stew. I don't know if I can confirm that. I don't know what sex stew is. Maybe it is taboo. I'd like to know more about sex stew before I, you know, just agree to that without even hearing more about it. I'm not going to sign off on sex stew. It sounds a little wild and weird. Don't commit me to that. No.
French treasure.
And then, like, that's a punchline, French treasure. I mean, come on. If I'm going to lay any criticism against this, it's just stupid. It's just not funny. French treasure? That's a line you wrote in there? That's a punchline? French treasure? Okay. Oh, French treasure in your sex stew, bye.
Because my sex junk is so, much more than even. If they're alive, I'll date them.
If they're alive, I'll date them? That's your only criteria? They just need to be alive? That seems like a little too lenient, lady. Let's set some standard here. If they're alive, does that include kids? Just cough myself into a coma. Just give me 1 second here. Oh my goodness. If they're alive, I'll date them. Let's have some standards. Not kids. Maybe not if they're in a coma. Not if they're drunk. Let's set some standards here, lady. Anything. Okay. Sex, I guess maybe that's what a sex stew is. You just throw everything in there and you just fuck. Nice. But this is what I'm saying. The way that they portray this is super problematic for their cause. It seems to be self-defeating. Because anyone who's a proponent of gay rights and trans rights is like, look at these freaks. And I have to say, the way that they're portraying it, that's true. That's not how it is, but it's just fucked up.
Your genitatum, I'm down for anything. Don't box in my box. Give someone new a handy.
Give someone new a handy. What are you saying? Just go find a random stranger and give them a handy? This is not like this. I find it hard to believe that trans and gay people watch this and be like, yup, that's what I'm doing all day. I'm out there having sex still, slurping it up, giving new people handies. This is the life that I live. It's almost like this lady's undercover just to like set back the cause by a whole decade. Like, I'm sorry, this shit is just dumb.
Then give yourself props.
Oh, you think you're so.
Anyway, just kind of, you get the idea. So this is my problems with this. Again, just to reemphasize, I don't think that gay and trans people are sick. That's ridiculous. If you think that, you're a bigot. But the way they're portrayed in this video is absolutely can't, my bro. Continuing with this, I have another Bill Nye clip. Again, which I think probably is what pissed off a lot of people. And caused a lot of controversy among more conservative people. And again, understandably so. So I want to explain why, on one hand, I defend gay and trans rights, and how come this video is ridiculous? Let's have a look.
Forward thinking, but not everyone sees it this way. But there are lots of flavors to sexuality.
Hell yeah.
Why are we here, Vanilla?
Damn!
Oh, this again? Come on!
Chillax, Straubs!
Settle, everybody. Settle. Now, I've spoken to some of you about my theories on the nature of being ice cream.
Which have no basis in science.
It's the science of feeling. And as Vanilla, I feel that I am the most natural of the ice creams.
Okay, so here they're parodying essentially straight men, straight religious men, who try to convert gay people to be straight. And that's a worthy cause. I think gay conversions are some of the most obscene things that exist in today. It's like it's sick. I really do think so. So here they're pairing it, and I think that's a good point. But it starts to get a little bizarre after this point.
And therefore, the rest of you should just go ahead and also be vanilla. Oh, it's the one true flavor.
No! Don't make me stop being strawberry delicious.
Oh, Christ. Look, no one can make you stop being strawberry. Strawberry.
You're strawberry. Hope be salted, caramel.
I just think if you want to get right with the big ice cream in the sky, change your flavor by wishing to be vanilla.
What if the big ice cream in the sky is chocolate?
Blasphemy. Everyone should pretend to be vanilla until they no longer have the urge not to be vanilla.
Wow! Such an unnecessary punctuation of that point.
I did not urge to be.
All right, get on with the point. Yada, yada, yada.
Sorry, I'm late.
So this is when it starts to get real weird and wild, and they kind of get off track again, like in the music video.
Two awesome things at once.
Cool.
Not cool. Pick a lane, butt stain.
Vanilla's trying to convert us all.
I love the laughter they put in there. Pick a lane, butt stain. This isn't for kids. There was literally laughter at pick a lane, butt stain. You're telling me this is not packaged for kids. Okay. I'd like to see you try that in front of an adult crowd and see how many laughs you get.
Again.
That's nuts. No offense, nuts. Come on, Vanilla. Nobody wants.
Boy, that nuts joke really killed, am I right? Did you guys catch that? That was huge.
It's just one flavor of ice cream.
I do.
Haven't you ever wanted to be in a Neapolitan?
So here's they go. Okay, so I guess the ice creams are supposed to represent different spectrums of sexuality. The white one, he's a straight guy. And at this point, she says, hasn't everybody ever wanted to try different flavors? Insinuated that every single person isn't straight. Which is kind of a radical implication, right? That any straight male or female actually does want to have sex with the opposite gender. They're just too shy. I think that's a little bit of a scene. If we're going to acknowledge that gay and trans people exist, we have to acknowledge that just straight straight people exist. It's possible, guys. I hate to break it to you, but there are people who just want to have sex with the opposite gender. It's out there, guys. So this one gets a little weird.
I can't.
Come on.
And now they're pushing him into having an orgy. This is kind of like rapey, to be honest. This is like ice cream rape.
Natural. All natural cocoa.
And strawberry fresh from the field.
It's so creamy and delicious.
Also, like, there's a little too many genders here going on. How many? Goddamn, buddy. Shit, buddy. It's a little too spicy for me.
Big ice cream in the sky, help me. It's good.
Okay, so this is just kind of like sick, honestly, at this point. So they're just having a giant orgy. They push this guy. They convince this vanilla ice cream, who was a bigot to begin with, into having a big, giant, gay orgy, kind of. And I think the worst thing that I think that inflamed people on the right is that this insinuation that everybody's gay, everybody wants to have homosexual relationships, you just haven't been coerced into it. And that's just ridiculous. That's just obscene. So in a way, I understand why. And again, I think the message is just completely off here. It's completely wrong. I totally understand why people are not down with this Bill Nye stuff. Besides that, that peanuts joke killed. If you guys go back and watch that peanuts joke, that absolutely killed. And I'll always give them credit for that joke. That being said, enjoy this.
We get the bull.
This is on. Oh, yeah.
Anyway, yada, yada, yada. They all melt together. You know how it is. So that's Bill Nye. Hope you guys enjoyed that little segment. And now let's move it on. Trump's new tweet. Oh, spicy, spicy. Breaking news. We have a tweet from your President Donald Trump. This has been up for 2 hours and has not been corrected. Despite the constant negative press, coffee. 2 hours this has been up. Wow. I mean, what do you say about that? Cough. Despite the constant negative press, cough. What do you think he was trying to type, Hila? It looks like he typed coffee, but it just got a little wacky for him. Despite the negative press, coffee. On to our next story. Ethan Bradberry is back. He has been all over the place. He is a true entrepreneur of YouTube. Pranks, Spider-Man and Elsa. Now what has he moved on to? Sunset Park. That's right. So this is Sunset Park's What's Inside the Box Challenge. And this one is a little wild, a little wacky. No animals were harmed in the during of No animals were harmed during this challenge. I'll be the judge of that.
Welcome back to Sunset Park. Hi. This week we got our homie, Rich the Kid.
Battler.
The money way.
The box way.
So this week what we got to do is put an animal in the box, and then we have two holes in the box, and you got to try to touch the animal and guess the animal, and yeah.
Guess the animal.
Guess
the animal. Go ahead. Don't look.
Don't worry, it's not
going to
bite you.
It's not going to bite you. Really, try to feel it.
This is so epic. This is so epic, you guys. So what they did is they clearly went to a pet shop, and they bought a whole assortment of animals, you'll see. And my question is, what do they do with them? Because I don't think these guys are actually capable of taking care of pets. So watch as this video evolves, about when you kind of turns into this weird, like, animal torture, like, fetish almost, which I'm kind of into, which I like. That's why I smashed like on this video. Who's this kid, man? I don't like this kid, Rich Kid. You could tell, by the way, look, you'll notice throughout this video, look where Rich Kid's looking right now. Like, why are you looking at the corner of a room? They probably have a preview there, and all these hunks can't take their eyes off themselves. Look where he's looking. He can't even look at the lens. He's just staring at himself. Watch this. We're right here, Rich Kid. We're right here, dog. Look at us. I do respect Rich Kid saying something about touching something furry. Huge observation. Earth-shaking. Amazing, momentous. This is some great content, and Ethan Bradberry is up next, so you know it's going to be good. Watch where Ethan Bradberry takes the animal out, bites its head off, and just is like, do you not know who I am? This is Ethan! And everyone's just like, freaks out. Would love that. So they thought it'd be a good idea to put a bird. They actually put a bird in a box and covered it in saran wrap. It's a bird. It's a flying creature. A real-life flying creature in a little box for Ethan Bradberry, of all people, to manhandle. And then they put no animals were harmed in the making of this video. Let's see. Also, by the way, do you guys notice how Rich Kid bounced? Dude, fuck that kid, Rich Kid. He just bounced out. He's like, put me first, and then I'm going to bounce. Who is that kid? Why does he think so highly of himself?
Yo, what is it?
Go, it's, oh, no. It's in there.
Go.
Oh, my God.
So Ethan Bradberry said it bit me. So this is the point in the show where Ethan Bradberry actually contracted avian flu and some new type of bird super AIDS. So basically this is ground zero of the zombie apocalypse, starting with Ethan Bradberry, which is just so fitting.
Yo, it's flying. What the hell?
It's flying. He's shocked. And frankly, he should be. You shouldn't put a flying animal in a box with saran wrap and have Ethan Bradberry manhandle it. Anyway, it's just, it's a lot of laughs, honestly. This has kind of been, look at this. Put like a giant hamster in the box. What are they going to do with all these animals? These guys are not capable of taking care of these animals.
It's like skittish.
I feel like at the end of this, they're going to have a battle royale where they just put all the animals in a cage and see which one is triumphant, and then that's the one that they keep. Regardless, guys, honestly, Sunset Park has been one of the most exciting channels I've been following, because this is a really captivating reality show where, like, they all upload their personal video every day of the week, and some get more views than other, right? A little drama, like, oh shit, like, Colby Person's kind of low on the views. Well, shit, dude, I don't know if he should be keep being part of the Sunset Park Boulevard, right? Also, I love the name Sunset Park. Maybe it makes me think of like a place where you want to go on a date and have a sweet kiss. But maybe you follow Ethan Bradberry into the park. It's Sunset Park. The sun's going down. It's about to get dark. Do you really want to follow Ethan Bradberry into a park? Lots of wood. Maybe not easy to escape. Maybe not a lot of public buildings, public people, light posts, for example. All of a sudden, it's nighttime park. It's nighttime park, and you're in there with Ethan Bradberry. You don't know which way you came in because he brought you in, turned you around. You're a little confused. You're a little scared. All of a sudden, you're in a park with Ethan Bradberry. It's a midnight park. Maybe it's not as romantic and charming as it was when it was Sunset Park. That's why I love this channel. Does that make sense to you guys? Let's move on to the next one. TechRax smashes a play button. This one I do like quite a bit. I love TechRax. He is an absolute golden god of YouTube. He makes the best content with, like, what I love about TechRax is that there's a point to all of his videos, right? Like, there's a clear intention, a clear purpose with all of his videos, which just makes me excited. So here, this one is called Smashing My Gold YouTube Play Button. Apparently, these are worth like $7,000 in precious metals, which is kind of cool.
Guys,
it's nice to know that when I hit rock bottom, nobody watched our videos anymore, I'll have a play button that I'll be able to hopefully smelt into small gold coins to float myself for another month.
TechRax here, so really sorry I have to do this, guys, but the time has come. My 1 million subscriber gold play button. Let's go ahead and give it a little bit of some treatment. There we go. Give it a little bit of this.
A little bit of that, a little bit of this, a little hey, how you doing? My name's TechRax, guys. Let's smash a drone into a pool of Coca-Cola. Okay, give it a little. I don't know why he lit it on fire. I don't think that has any practical effect. I think a sledgehammer is probably enough to break through glass. A
little bit of this.
Yeah. Oh. Woo. Woohoo. Yeah. Yep.
It's a very powerful, strong sound.
Yes. Wow.
As you guys can see,
this is
beautiful
amazing.
Gold play button.
The best part is that you just don't expect it, right? Like, when you take a sledgehammer to glass of the object that a lot of people want and covet, a lot of people dream of getting that $1 million subscriber. It's fascinating because you just don't expect it, right? When you bring a sledgehammer down on glass. I'm so shocked that it broke, especially when you lit it on fire. I mean, this whole thing is just so surprising. This made me like super nervous, by the way. Watching this numbskull actually try to tear glass off this thing made me very nervous. Your mom would not be happy with this, TechRax. Careful, dog. That's glass. Somebody just left? Dude, oh my god, fresh drama. Fuck this shit. I'm going to Sunset, but that's what I was saying. It's like the most exciting thing on YouTube because it's happening. You never know, man. People are already getting voted off the island. Sunset Park. You have got to be kidding me. My final goodbye? It's like he died or some shit. He filmed it on a vertical cam. My final goodbye. Oh, this is too good.
Hey, guys. It's Sam here. I hope you guys are all having a
wonderful day. Oh, it's got sad music. No! I can't believe this is such a fresh scoop. Sam Des, he was one of my favorites. He was such a cutie pie, and he's only 15 years old. I love it.
Wonderful Tuesday. But I'm making this video to let you guys know that I'm leaving the Sunset Park house.
No! Sam!
Too much. So I decided to come back to Virginia.
He lasted 1 week. He moved out there from Virginia. My final goodbye. He lasted 1 week with Ethan Bradberry, you guys.
I wanted to let you guys know that I'm gonna still be vlogging on my personal channel. Links will be in the description below, but
I feel like he's trying to act sad. I love it. I love it. He's got braces and he's living with Ethan Bradberry. Not anymore.
Other than that, don't give anyone in the Sunset Park house any hate or anything.
Hell yeah.
Thanks, guys. That's all. Bye.
Oh no. No, they made, oh my god. They made a memorial video. He was there for 1 week. I think he made two videos max. And they made an actual montage memorial. Are you seeing this shit, Hila? Yeah. They made a fucking memorial! Oh, they did a slow-mo! Then they dissolved into his shoulder. They did a dissolve into his shoulder. Look at this transition into his shoulder. They dissolved into his shoulder, you guys. Damn, rest in peace, Sam. Oh my gosh. Not like this, Sam. Oh no. Not like this, Sam. Oh my god, no. Oh my god. Ethan Bradberry loves Sam Dez. Oh. Oh my god. No. I gotta pause. This is way too emotional, you guys. I can't believe Sam Dez. He lasted 2 weeks. That's actually so awesome that they literally just posted this video. Rest in peace, Sam Dez. I think this is a perfect place to end the live stream, you guys, because frankly, it's getting a little too emotional for me. Well, I'm glad you guys liked it, but it was really fun. I'm glad I got to come and hang out with you guys and try it out. Anyway, guys, was a blast. And thank you all so much for your generous donations. You guys are amazing. Appreciate y'all so much.